So to start with rigging, I'm going to go ahead and delete the skeleton. So you might want to go into the display panel, make sure that under hide by category, the bone objects and all the other stuff are not hidden. I do have cameras hidden right now just because I'm not working with them. So select objects. I'm selecting everything except for the mesh. And I'm going to hit delete. You can see that that messed up that mesh. Why is that? It's because I still have physique on, so I'm just going to delete that. Okay, so now what I have here is what you should be starting with, a basic editable mesh. This is in your modifier panel. Now the first thing that you need to do in order to rig is create a skeleton. 3D Max makes this really easy to do if you use Biped. You go into the Create panel. At the very end here, you have Systems, and you get these options. You can make bones, you can make a biped. Now for a character, especially an upright humanoid character, biped is the easiest thing to do. What you have here is different options. I'm using 3D Max 9, and older versions have a few less options, and I think newer versions might have more options. Right here, I'll just make a few, and you can check it out. I'm in biped mode. I'm going to click and drag. That's a biped. It's a classic body type. That's a female. Male, and a skeleton. Now, I think just because I'm old school, I like the classic body type, but you can choose whichever one you want. Now, strangely enough, it helps to rename the root right here in the Create panel. If you rename it later, it tends to only rename the root, not the entire skeleton. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this thing. And before I make my new biped, first of all, I'm going to go into front perspective by pressing F, so that when I click and drag, it'll be pretty close to the goblin, or close to the goblin's height. I'm going to decide what I want. Do I want arms? Yes. One neck link? I think two or three spine links is good. These all seem good. It doesn't have a tail. Ponytail links, these can be for anything on the head. So I could use a ponytail link to make the hat move, or the ears move, or the jaw move. So I'm going to go ahead and give it one ponytail link. And you can have two different ponytails, by the way. So that would be if you had two different ears, or pigtails. Anyway, I gave it one link, and I'm going to use that for the jaw. Fingers. You will see that although I've rendered some fingers on this goblin, it does not have mesh fingers. If I hit F4 to see the whole mesh, you can see that the fingers are not individual, because this is a pretty low poly mesh. So I think I'm just going to stick with one finger to give it sort of a glove look. That's it. I'm ready to create my skeleton. So front view mode. And I am going to click in the middle and drag it up. You don't need to worry about getting this too exact, and we'll get into that later. So now I'm going to rename it Gob as the name of the skeleton. And you can name yours whatever you'd like. Hit return to make sure it sticks. And now when you go into any other mode and hit H, you will see your entire biped skeleton right there.